Welcome at my channel Acreage, the channel for game tutorials and more. In this tutorial we are going to make a classic snake game in Godot. Make a new scene and rename the basic node with your right mouse button and rename it as snake. Add a area 2D node with a sprite and a collision shape 2D. As of course all of us love the Godot logo, we will use it as the head of our snake. Drag the logo in the texture field and resize its values in the transform skill X and Z. And for the collision shape 2D, we will add in a rectangle shape and adjust its size. Attach a new script on the basic node which we have called snake. On top of our script we will create the variable for the direction and make it a vector 2D value. I like to give the snake some speed to start, so I'll set its x value to 5. We will use this variable to create a movement in the process delta function. I use input as action press UI up and set the direction vector 2D value to 0, minus 5, which direct to the I value. And for making the snake moving downwards, we will use a positive 5. The same we will do for the X value for the left and the right, sending to minus 5 and positive 5. Now we need to create a function which uses this information to change the position of the snake. So we will set a new move underscore snake and create that function to set a variable to get the head position. Create the variable head position and get underscore node. To make the scripting code easier, we first want to rename the area2d node into head, so we can use it with get underscore node head dot position. We created this variable to use later for its body, but for the head we will just use get underscore node named head position and add the direction divided by 2. You can save the scene with the short keys Ctrl S and test this scene to see if your snake is moving. Make a new scene for the gear, change the basic node into an area 2D node, add a sprite and a collision shape 2D, and drag a gear icon on the sprite texture and adjust its size. Select a circle shape for the collision shape 2D and adjust the shape as well. Create a script for the gear and get back on the scene tab to activate the signal on the collision enter area 2D. This signal is automatically added in your new script. In this new function we will check if the object collides with the head, and in that case we destroy the gear and create a signal to reuse this check with emit signal name. Save the scene and create a new scene for the main scene and rename its node as level. Link the snake in the scene and attach a script on the level node. Connect the gear icon with the level with the unready for gear is preload and add the gear scene. In the function underscore ready we will call the function add gear and we will create the function add gear manually and recall the gear instance. With the var instance is gear instance and set its position vector 2D, x and y value on a random position with the rand underscore range. I will use 900,50, but you can use any other numbers. You will do this both for the x and the y value. Next we will recall if the signal of the snake and the gear interacts, and if it has been activated. When they collide we will tell our level to respawn by itself the gear in a new function with a spanner and add the child. In the new function we just called, we will recall the addGear function. When playtesting the new code, I noticed that I shouldn't use 900 and change it into 500. Add a label node as a child on the level for showing the score. In the script we will add a variable for the score and set it to 0. We need to show the score at every frame, so we use a process delta function and change the score.txt into points plus the variable score which we need to change into a string to be presented on the screen. On the respawn function we also add the score with a plus 5 to add the score with 5 when we collide with the gear. Add a new scene for the body or the tail, change its basic node into an area 2D node as well. Add a sprite and collision 2D, change its texture, adjust its size and add a rectangle shape on the collision shape 2D and adjust its size. In the same way as we did before, we first attach a script and add the signal of the area entered and connect it with our script. In this new function we just created, we will check with the if statement if the area.name is head, and if that is true we will reset the game with get underscore tree reload current scene. Delete the unready function and create the process delta function. and change its position within. First, we need a new variable on top of our script, where we are calling a new vector2d position. I will call it curdir, which I divide by 2. On top of our script, we will also make two variables for two different arrays to make different values for the different positions and directions of all the parts of the tails. In the process delta, we will add the if statement to check if the array is empty or not. This because if we haven't touched the gear, we don't want to have any tail at all. Create a new function called removeFromTail and use the pop underscore front function on the direction array and the position array to set its array to null. We will create another function with an opposite effect. We will call it addToTail, which we will call on our snake script and set the position array and direction. And use dot append with the values which we will receive from the script of the snake, which we are going to script later on. Let's get back to our level script and add a get underscore node snake and call the new function add underscore tail, which we are going to script next. Add the new function in our snake script, function add underscore tail. Be aware you type it exactly the same as in the level script. We also add three new variables on top of our script, one for the space in between the tails, which I set to -7, but you can tweak with this number. Just be aware that if the gap is too small, you can create an infinite loop of dying. The next two variables are two vector2d ones, one for the next tail direction and one for the previous direction. And don't forget to add an unready variable with the preload instance of the tail. In the addTail, we call the instance of the tail and we make a tail checker with the get underscore child get child count -1, so that if we check that if the previous tail name is not had, we will set the instance as the new previous tail. We will also use the I in a range loop to check how many tails we need to add. With the for I in range, 0 previous tail post array size. If the tail exists, we set its direction and position according to that of the snake, with the pos underscore array dot append, and for every different tail part. This makes instance.position is previous tail.position plus previous tail.corridor times the gap. After the if statement, we will set an else statement. So if the previous tail name is head, then we set instance.curdir equal to direction and instance.position equal to previous tail.position plus direction times the gap. This is to reset the values if we restart. At last, we add the child. Now we need in the move snake function to make the tail pieces also changing direction every frame when the snake does. First we will make a check if the direction has changed, with a variable direction underscore change. If the previous direction is not equal to direction, it means that the direction has changed, so we will set dir underscore change to true. If dir underscore change is true, we will set the loop to change the direction for all the different tail parts, with for I in range is 1 because we don't want to change the heads. Get child count and get child I. Add to the group and we can check in our tail script which values we need to set, the head underscore position and the dir. In the getChild, add to the tail properties. Before I will check all these new functions, I want to readjust the size of the collision of the tail to prevent an infinite death loop. Save all your changes and play the Godot Snake game. Well done finishing this tutorial. Let me know if you like this tutorial and don't forget to subscribe to miss none of my content. For next week, I will explain how to manage double jumps. This was Acreates. Make more, enjoy more.